Joël, we've got quite a few questions to get through for fans to know you a little better. You ready?
Yes,
should
I
we get
am.
Started?
Yes.
Right, first one. What are three things you would take with you on a desert island?
Football.
Yeah.
My girlfriend, of course, to keep me company.
Yeah.
And, yeah, probably food.
What else do you need? What is a job you would have done if you weren't a footballer?
I would probably do something with economics. I really loved it.
Really?
Yes.
Were you good at maths in school?
Yeah, actually, I am.
Yeah, maybe one day. You never know. What's your favorite meal?
Surinamese dish, but kind of like nasi with chicken.
Is there something you miss when you're in Swansea, like your home cooked food? Or do you give it a go yourself?
Yeah, I give it a go myself, but it's not as good as my mom's cooking.
What was the last film you watched?
No clue.
It was a long time ago.
No.
Do you watch me? No.
Yeah, I just don't remember. Probably Doctor Strange, I think.
Right?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy it?
It was alright.
Okay.
Not the best one.
What is your favourite TV series?
TV series? Is that from the UK or from
Holland? Could be anything.
Well, actually, I love NBA Today to watch it. It's on ESPN.
Yeah.
And yeah, just special.
So you're a big fan of basketball, aren't you?
Yeah, I am.
Who's your team?
Well, yeah, it's difficult to say because it's a bit Messi or Ronaldo question.
Yeah.
Like LeBron James obviously is amazing, but Stephen Curry as well. So I just enjoy them, how good they are.
Have you always followed basketball or is it quite recent?
No, I've followed it since, I think, 2011.
Oh, quite a while.
Yeah.
Yeah. Have you been to any games?
No, not yet.
No,
not
yet. One day.
One day.
Your favourite musician or band?
Yeah, I would say Burna Boy at the moment.
Burna Boy?
Yeah.
Yeah. Summer or winter?
Summer, 100%.
Favourite fashion brand?
Yeah. Fashion brand, yeah. Louis Vuitton for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have to say Dior is nice as well.
I know your outfit on the first day of preseason split opinion. Some people were fans, some people not so much. I'm not naming any names, but...
No, I'm real curious, actually.
I'll tell you off camera, because I'm not stitching anyone up.
It's fine.
Amsterdam or London?
Amsterdam, 100%. Like, the shops are pretty much the same, but like, food in Holland is just better than here in the UK.
If you had a time machine, where would you go? It can be any place in history, it can be an era.
Wow, that's a difficult one. Like living in Stone Age or something would be like spectacular. Because you have like no idea how it should have been. But obviously you have great moments like Holland winning the European Cup, something that's special that you want to see.
Yeah.
Or Michael Jordan in action, or maybe some other great sportsmen, so it's hard.
Difficult question, that one. What's on your bucket list?
After my career, I really would like to go snowboarding once.
Really?
Yeah, I really like it. Of course, we can't do it now, but that's for sure on my bucket list.
What's your biggest phobia?
I'm really scared of heights, like... standing on a balcony or something, and like if it's high,
you know, not a
like
fan.
No, not a fan at
Pato
all.
Pato said the same, but he did a skydive.
Did he?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, but everybody knows he has some problems in his head.
He's not all that. What's the best concert you've ever been to?
The Chris Brown concert in Holland.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You haven't seen Burna Boy yet?
Nah.
No. No.
Didn't have time for it.
World Cup or Champions League?
World Cup.
Yeah.
Yeah. Will be the first one for Holland, so.
Who is the person you admire most in life?
My dad.
Yeah?
Yeah, for sure. Like, how he got where he is now and how he helps me every day. Something I really respect.
Now, one thing I've got to ask is, your parents came over this year, didn't they? How did they find travelling to the Cardiff game on the supporters bus? Because I heard that there was chanting on the bus, they were singing your song, and then they were just sitting there clapping away.
Yeah, it's of course something special because it's their name as well.
Yeah.
They see me in a different way than supporters do, obviously. And it's just, you live for those moments, like it's feeling that you're getting somewhere where you want to be, and that's just really nice.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Economics.
Economics, yeah.
Yeah.
It's usually PE, so I'm glad it's something different.
Nah, we weren't allowed to do that in Holland.
Oh, really?
Nah, like if you played for a football team, you wasn't allowed to be.
Right. So focus on economics instead.
Yeah.
City or countryside?
City.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not a hard one.
Early bird or night owl?
Really depends. Like if you have the day off, then of course night owl. But like, I don't mind to get up early as well.
A bit of both.
Yeah, a bit of both.
If you could have any superpower, what would you choose?
Flying.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would get rid of my scared of heights. I hope so.
You forget about that.
Yeah.
Have you picked up any Welsh words?
Yeah, of course, when you're driving, you see some words like,
don't worry.
But Araf?
Yeah, slow.
Slow, and a couple more that you just know because when you drive, you just see them.
It's a start.
Yeah, it's a start.
You'll get there. Yeah. You'll be fluent in no time. What's your most prized possession?
Probably my feet.
Yeah. It's a good one. If you could be anyone else for a day, who would it be?
I would love to be like Burna Boy.
Burna Boy, yeah?
Yeah, like...
He's a cool guy.
Yeah, and something completely different from...
From
sports.
Yeah.
Exactly, and just enjoying life. But also... Well. Yeah, living well.
One goal or two assists?
What's the score? 0-0?
0-0, yeah.
Then I will go for a goal. No, both is fine. If you win, it's both fine, yeah.
I'm not sure if you're a reader, or what was the last book you read?
Nah, I don't read books. Only when I had to go to school, I read my books, but...
Not so not, fun.
Nah.
Prefer TV series.
Yeah, TV series or on my tablet, just.
What is a song you know word for word?
It's a song of a friend of mine. He's from Suriname, Del. And if you translate how it's called, it is Motivation.
Right.
Yeah.
Would you say that's your favorite song too?
One of.
What's the best thing about Swansea?
The best thing about Swansea? I would say how the people are.
Yeah.
Like they're very chilled and it's just a good environment to live, actually.
Who is your best friend in football?
Yeah, that's Pablo Rosario.
Yeah.
He now plays at Nice, but when we played together at PC, we were just always together.
What's the best atmosphere in a game you played in?
I would say the home game against Cardiff.
Yeah.
That's the best atmosphere. Especially because our fans didn't leave after 55 minutes.
Yeah.
It's true.
Who is the greatest player of all time?
R9.
Yeah.
No, yeah. Just a pity that he couldn't do it for longer.
Your sporting icon?
Probably Michael Jordan.
Yeah.
Yeah. His work ethics and just... able to overcome anything is amazing.
And even after he's retired from playing, what he's gone on to do is special. Exactly. Your favorite football kit ever?
I really have no clue.
Really?
Yeah, I would probably say like the first time, like in Holland, when you play for the national team, I think until the under 15s, you played in like orange top or something, but without the Dutch logo, the badge.
Yeah.
So. The first time when we really got the national shirts, that was a a really nice moment. So I would say because of the switch, that was a real treasure moment.
Do you keep many of your shirts?
Well, don't ask the material people, but I did keep quite a lot of shirts last season. Yeah.
Especially like when you score, like the Blackpool game, for example, when you score a goal like that. Yeah. Is that something to look back on that with then?
Yeah, 100%. And as well, like, I love to give my shirts away, especially when I see how the fans treat me, then you just want to give them something back. Of course, on the pitch, that's first and foremost important thing. But, like, yeah, if you do well, you can just give them a shirt as well.
We won't tell Mike the kit man. We'll keep that a secret. Do you have any pre-match superstitions?
Superstitions?
Can somebody... do you have to put your left boot on before your right boot?
Oh, no, I don't need to do that, no.
No?
No.
Just go with the flow.
Yeah, that's the best thing to do.
Who is the best player you've ever played with?
Difficult one. Like, if you would look at people's careers, I would say Stephen Bergwijn or Denzel Dumfries, because of the place where they are now. Yeah. Like, they're playing on the top stage. But, some other players, like Doyle Malo, also very good. So, probably one of them.
Yeah. What's your favourite goal you've ever seen live? So, this could be when you were playing. It could be when you're a fan in the stand.
Yeah, of course. I have to put my own goal against Blackpool in there as well. Or the Luton goal, because of the score, the minute, everything. But there was one moment when I was watching PSV against Barcelona in Champions League. Lost it, came 2-1, and Messi just did something that nobody expected. There were like six bodies around him, and he was inside the box.
Yeah.
A little bit on a tough angle as well. And he just chops it to the left and whips it in short corner. And everybody was watching, like, what just happened? Yeah. Even the goalkeeper was just looking, like, what's just happened? Yeah.
So, are you team Messi on the Messi-Ronaldo debate? Controversial one.
Yeah, it's... I got told to stay away from those questions. But, I really love Messi. It's just... Yeah. So talentful. His touches, his technique... Something I really love, but then Ronaldo obviously is just a real machine. Like, if you would say you don't really feel talented or not that talented, then he is the prime example to work hard.
Who is the funniest player you've ever played?
Only can be one. The weirdest guy in the group. Nah, he's great, Jamie. 100%.
Yeah. Keeps it entertaining.
Always.
What's the best piece of advice you've ever been given?
Actually, that was before I came to Swansea. I had a chat with the parents from Tai Chong.
Yeah.
And of course, he went on loan to Birmingham. I came here to Swansea, and it was quite funny, actually. We met on vacation, and... they were telling me, like, Joe, don't forget, you have to come here and just do your thing. And, like, from the first day, chest up, just believe in yourself. And it was something, like, most of the time when people try to encourage you, it's like it's your parents or your agent. But it just hits different when someone else does it, like, especially when you don't see each other that often.
Exactly, yeah.
And it also shows some trust that other people have in you.
We're on to the final question. So who would you say is the person that has had the most influence on your career?
Yeah, that's 100% my dad. Yeah? Yeah, 100%. From extra training sessions, just the two of us, or with some friends, or... Yeah, anything at all, like watching clips or just talking about situations. Why did you make this decision or that decision? And of course, the joy that I always have when I'm just watching football with my dad and just discussing it, especially as an only child. It's really nice to have like that, father son, but also brotherly bond.
Yeah. Well, thank you. I'm going to leave you go because I know you've got another training session.
Yes, you got to go again.
A long day. But thank you.
Yes, no problem.